Assalamu alaikum. I am Jahangir Alam. Today I am going to discuss about IGCSE O-level physics changing state. Today I am going to discuss how a substance turns into one state from another state. First, we have to learn about melting. What is melting? Melting is another name is fusion. Melting is a physical process that result in the phase transition of a substance from a solid to liquid. This occurs when internal energy of the solid increases, typically by the application of heat or pressure, when increase the substance temperature to the melting point. So melting is the process by which a solid substance turns into liquid state is known as melting point. Now melting point of a substance is the temperature at which it changes state from solid to liquid. At the melting point, the solid and liquid phase exist in equilibrium. The melting point of a substance depends on pressure and is usually specified at a standard pressure such as 1 atmosphere pressure or 100 kilopascal. So melting point at standard pressure, the temperature at which a solid turns into liquid state is known as melting point. Now boiling is the process. Boiling is a process by which a liquid turns into vapor or its gaseous state when it is heated to its boiling point. The change from liquid phase to a gaseous phase occurs when the vapor pressure of the liquid is equal to the atmospheric pressure exerted on the liquid. So boiling is the process by which a liquid substance turns into gas. Boiling point of a substance is the temperature at which a vapor pressure of the liquid equals to the pressure surrounding to the liquid, and the liquid changes into vapor. The boiling point of the liquid varies depending upon the surrounding environmental pressure. So boiling point is defined as the at standard pressure, the temperature at which a liquid substance turns into gas is known as boiling point. Now evaporation. What is evaporation? Evaporation is a process by which an element or compound transition from its liquid state to its gaseous state below the temperature at which it boils. Particularly, the process by which a liquid water enters the atmosphere as water vapor. So evaporation is a slow and steady process where a liquid substance turns into gaseous state from its upper surface below the boiling point. That means evaporation takes place at any temperature and pressure. So evaporation is a natural process. So the evaporation, the process by which a liquid turns into its gaseous state slowly and steadily without application of any kind of heat and pressure. So evaporation takes place at any temperature and pressure. Sublimation. Sublimation is the transition of a substance directly from solid to gas state without passing through the liquid state. Now heat capacity. Heat capacity is the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature by one unit. So the amount of heat energy required to rise the temperature by 1 Kelvin is known as heat capacity. Heat capacity denoted by C. C equals to Q, amount of heat energy required, divided by change in temperature. Unit is Joule per Kelvin. Joule per Kelvin. Now, specific heat capacity. Specific heat capacity, it is denoted by S. So, amount of heat energy required per unit mass. Per unit mass to rise the temperature by 1 unit or 1 Kelvin or 1 degree Celsius is known as specific heat capacity. It is the material characteristics. So for any substance, for like water, the specific heat capacity of water is 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin. That means 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin. The SI unit of specific heat capacity is joule per kg per Kelvin. Now latent heat. Latent heat. Latent means hidden. Heat means thermal energy. So amount of thermal energy or heat energy required to change the state of a substance without changing its temperature is known as latent heat. So latent heat of fusion means the amount of heat energy required per unit mass to rise amount of heat energy required per unit mass to change its state, solid state to liquid state without changing its temperature. That means at boiling, at melting point. So unit joule per kg, joule per kg. On the other hand, latent heat of vaporization, it is denoted by LV, the amount of heat energy required per unit mass to change its state from liquid to vapor without changing its temperature, that means at boiling point, is known as vaporization, latent heat of vaporization. To calculate the heat energy transfer, Q equal to M is the mass, S is the specific heat capacity, and delta T is the change in temperature. So M is the mass, S is the specific heat capacity, T2 is the final temperature, T1 is the initial temperature. Unit of heat energy transfer, Q equal to M S delta T. Unit is joule. If amount of heat energy transfer or required to change its state from solid to liquid at boiling point can be calculated by using this formula. Q equals to mass into latent heat of fusion. On the other hand, amount of heat energy required can be calculated by using this formula when any substance turns into liquid to gas without changing temperature, that means at boiling point.
Amount of heat energy is denoted by Q, and formula is mass multiplied by specific heat capacity into change in temperature. So Q equal to M into S into delta T. Unit will be joule. Unit will be joule, because the amount heat, the unit of heat energy equal to unit of the heat energy is joule. Now heat energy required when any substance turns into solid to liquid without changing temperature. So Q equals to mass into latent heat of fusion. This is the formula when any substance turns into solid state to liquid state. When liquid turns into gas without changing temperature, that means solid turns into liquid at at melting point, then we use this formula, Q equals to M into LF. Again, liquid turns into gas at boiling point, then we use this formula, Q equals to mass into latent heat of vaporization, Today, we do a mathematical problem related to changing state. Here, 250 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius is kept inside a container. We have to convert this liquid into water without changing temperature. Calculate the amount of heat energy required for the above process, or calculate the amount of heat energy required to convert 250 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius into 250 gram of water at 0 degree Celsius. So when a substance turns into solid to liquid without changing temperature, then we use this formula, Q equal to mass into latent heat of fusion. We know the latent heat of fusion of ice is 3.36 10 to the power 5 joule per kg. Here, mass of the ice is 250 gram. So, 250 gram into 3.36 10 to the power 5 joule per kg. We have to convert this 250 gram into kg by dividing 1000. So, 0.25 kg into 3.36 10 to the power 5 joule per kg. After multiplication, we get 84,000 joule.